So today, hello kids, today on Louisiana Beer Reviews, we are looking at an old beer, an old faithful beer that we both enjoyed very much through the years. This was one of the first beers I tried by Parish Brewing on a brew solid near Lafayette, Louisiana. And it was one of the ones that first came out with that haze craze, that New England style that everyone fell in love with. I tasted it, and it tasted really great, and then I went and, of course, tried their other beers, but I always came back to this one.
The Envie. You had an Envie for
it. Envie. An Envie means, like, really something great.
A craving. Like, you have an Envie for something. You have a craving.
So we're going to go ahead and pop this open, see what it tastes like. Of course, they all come in the red Parish label tops, and this is would be considered their basic base beer. This is pale ale.
And another one of their...
It's a hazed pale ale.
Yeah, and another one of their flagships is the Canebrake.
Canebrake. Yeah, Canebrake was a little too sweet for me.
The one made with the cane sugar.
Yeah.
So this is a revisit. We did this years ago.
Many, many years ago we did this one.
Yeah, well...
I could smell the hops coming off of this right now.
Yeah, it's hoppy. I don't know about dank, like people say. People use that word too much.
I'm not sure what they mean.
Everything is dank. It's dank.
They all of a sudden, it seems like people realize or came to the educational decision that hops are related to marijuana now. Everything's marijuana. You know, they had those marijuana beers come out.
The 420 beers.
420 beer, which we didn't really care for. The Hempinator. There was the Hemperer. All kind of, you know, and it really makes you wonder if the beers that are coming out now, the way they're labeled, marketed, and pushed out, and what they're saying about it, is it all just to hype it up so you can run behind them and say, oh yeah, I got it, and then when you get it, and you actually take all that labeling and bottling and hypeness and marketing, and you put it on the side, and you put it in a glass, and it's just you and the beer, and you taste it, what do you really get?
Well, in this case, we're getting some yeast chunks.
Yeah, you always get that from that. This one is...
This is milky like pineapple juice, man.
Well, kind of like that, and kind of like a thick lemonade.
It's almost got a gray...
Like a lemonade cream.
It's almost like a gray aspect to it, and the head is off-white, and like you say, once you get past the labeling and all that stuff... What do you have in the glass? This is an important question.
Right. Hey, kids, that's why we taste beers, because we like them, you know?
Right. It smells like hop oil.
And it's up to us to uncover what it is that's in this beer. Take away the label, take away the hype, take away all the advertisement, and pour it in the glass and say, hey, what's going on here?
And I am sensing pale malt.
Yes.
And fruity hops.
Yes.
I drank a beer the other day, and it said no flour was damaged in the making of this ale. You know, flour, like wheat flour.
Yeah. Or sometimes you use oat flour. Oat flakes. They'll even say sometimes with these. So I'm getting this pineapple forwardness going on with that. I can smell the pale
malt.
Oh, yeah.
Little sugary smell, sweet bread.
It's kind of like a pineapple forward. Yes. There's something else underneath. Green onion?
Green onion?
Like a green onion, maybe like a garlic note or something?
I don't know, I'm not getting that.
Anyway, it could be just my mind going off on differentness. So,
Merlotons. No, I don't know.
Let's go ahead and taste this. Its haziness is staying solid, so that's what I'm looking at.
Oh, it is hazy.
Yeah.
The taste. It's very low bitterness.
It's bitter. It's light.
I'm saying low bitter.
Yeah.
It has bitter at the back of the sip. Here.
It's grainy.
Grain, which is barley malt.
And then the bitterness kind of goes away, and then something else comes out. Lemon pith.
Yes.
It's pith. which isn't really always a great thing.
It's heavy bodied. It's fruity. There's white bread.
It's like lemon pith and pineapple and just this neutral grain thing going on with it. By the way, these beers change from batch to batch, how they put them out. So
I do find that. Now, we tried the double dry hop, the one with the black label, or was it the very dark green label? And I didn't find that the double dry hopping really significantly improved it.
I really didn't get on it. So, as a matter of fact, when I poured it out of the bottle, it seemed to be sprinkled along the top. But I don't know how they double dry hop it, but it was, there was like a casing that went up around the top of the bottle. So, but this is still coming in fairly decent.
Sorry about that. I told him I called
sitting, back. What's sitting in the back note of it is the fact that it's, that pith bitterness is just kind of lingering. So I'm just kind of, yeah. I'm not really kind of enjoying this as much as I should. It should be a clean finish. And it's just kind of
lumpy.
I wouldn't say lumpy. I don't know where that came from.
What I mean is like, that's not the right word, like a sloppy finish. Not sloppy.
And don't say what you don't need to say.
No, I'm trying to think of the right term. Like a rough, yeah, those are approximating what I'm trying to say. It's like a, it's not a clean finish. It's kind
no,
of
No, it's
a,
not. It's there's something missing from this. From the last time I had it, it's very enjoyable. Now it's kind of like lemon pith. It's kind of taking over the whole flavor of it.
Yeah, it's like a very citric acid type beer. I know it's coming from the hop oils. It's not coming from any kind of lemon or juice. There's no juice in this beer, okay?
And this is bottled on July 3rd this year. So I don't know if there's...
It's not even 2 months old.
If there's other viewers out there that maybe want to pick up a bottle from this date and maybe do a comparison. But it's tasting like there's something that's missing. It makes it a little...
I'm enjoying it, more or less. It might have been that we drank so many India pale ales that the pale ales aren't working for us anymore. They seem too bland or something. But
I didn't have any India pale ales today.
I just mean overall over the last few years. I do like pale ales, but if I was going to drink a pale ale, and I know this is a hazy, I understand that, but I would really pick, like, I would rather drink Sierra Nevada, you know, the old classic,
mm-hmm.
or even Dale's pale ale, which I don't see too much around here anymore. That's sort of like an IPA.
Dale's is too strong for a pale ale.
It's really an
IPA.
It's
6.5. There's no way that's a pale ale.
It's an India pale ale, really, in a practical sense. But anyway, I'll give this a B+.
I'm just going to give it a solid B because there's something missing in it. I mean, I don't know what's going on with this batch. Like I said, these guys have a tendency to tweak their batches from batch to batch. And this one is just... it's just got that bitter pith to me coming through just a little too strong. Not something that's really enjoyable. Because it's starting off with the pineapple and the kind of fruitiness going on and just kind of fell off.
And I had trouble describing it, but it could have been because I got
I've had this beer, I used to drink it a lot in the past. It seemed
like it was
really
better.
Really good. I'm not going to say better because this one just doesn't seem... quite there.
Okay, see, I'm going to say 88 out of 100. You're saying like 85?
Yeah, 83.
Oh, wow. Okay, so...
Step up your game, Parish.
So we're saying B to B+. Plus. What can we say? It is what it is. But that's the way it goes sometimes. So, laissez-les, bon temps, relais. That's the story. And we're going to end this review by saying, y'all come on down to Southeastern Louisiana.